AOC has declared that President Trump is Hitlerian. The only solution to Hitler is to depose him, and thus impeachment should be on the table. And Nancy Pelosi is really trying to rebridge that gap with AOC. She didn't like that fight that happened a couple of weeks ago. She wasn't fond of being called racist by AOC. Now, she had the upper hand for a moment, and then Trump proceeded to give AOC the upper hand. It is simply a fact that Pelosi was winning that fight. Most House Democrats had turned on AOC's chief of staff, Saikat Chakrabarty, who had ripped many members of the Congress, including some minority members of the Congress, as racists in the Jim Crow fashion. And Nancy Pelosi had basically sicked her dogs on Saikat Chakrabarty. Chakrabarty was losing. AOC was about to be marginalized, and then Trump stepped in and Leroy Jenkins the whole thing. Well, now AOC is trying to make peace with AOC, at least for the Pelosi's trying to make peace with AOC, at least for the foreseeable future. AOC met with Pelosi yesterday, and AOC, oh, you said, yeah, it's just we're making sure we're all on the same page.
I think the goal is just to open a line of communication and making sure that that we're all on the same page on everything. I think the objective is just that, to make sure that we're opening a line of communication, that all aspects of the party are on the same page, and to make sure that, you know, for me, as always, that working people have a seat at the table in what's happening in Congress.
Yeah, as opposed to Nancy Pelosi, who despises working people. Now, the good news is we have a visual representation of Nancy Pelosi's reaction to her meeting with AOC. So Pelosi tweeted out this picture. It's a picture of them standing next to one another. And she said, today, Congresswoman Representative AOC and I sat down to discuss working together to meet the needs of our district and our country, fairness in our economy, and diversity in our country. Nancy Pelosi looks like she wants to die. AOC is perfectly comfortable. Nancy Pelosi, who always looks as though the grin that she has is plastered onto her face, it looks as though it has been chiseled there with an actual chisel. And she looks so deeply uncomfortable. Somebody, I think it was Dan Foster from National Review, tweeted out that Nancy Pelosi should blink twice if she's okay. I mean, it does look like a hostage photo. Pelosi is deeply unhappy about this whole routine where she is supposed to pretend to be friends with AOC. And the reason she's deeply unhappy about that is because she knows that AOC's general strategy when it comes to the public debate is really dumb. And AOC proved that again yesterday. So AOC suggested that the GOP is running a torture program on the border. So not only are they running a concentration camp on the border, now it's a torture program on the border. Pretty soon she's going to be out there declaring that President Trump is running the island of Dr. Moreau on the border, where he's creating human-animal hybrids. You know, humans with pigs' faces and the hindquarters of a horse. Here's AOC with her latest slur on Border Patrol.
And how do you respond to Republicans who are talking about physical barriers being part of any package that deals with the actual crisis in terms of the traffic coming across the border?
If they want to do that, that's fine. Have them negotiate an appropriations. Have them make their case. But they should not be using a humanitarian crisis as a bargaining chip to make sure that they pursue their little torture project.
She's so obnoxious, and it's just such a lie. A torture project? You think that Border Patrol agents are interested in torturing people on the border? Now, Democrats are pointing to this Border Patrol Facebook group, and they're pointing to the fact that something like 10 Border Patrol agents posted comments in this Facebook group that are gross and nasty, and those agents are under investigation. And now they're trying to tie all 10,000 agents who are members of this Border Patrol group to those 10 commenters. So Huffington Post today has a piece called Trump's Border Patrol Chief Was in Secret Racist Facebook Group. Okay, you can't label the entire group racist because there are 10 commenters who say racist things in the comment section. That is not how Facebook works. It's amazing how people who cover tech for a living, who write for websites, don't seem to understand the very basic things about how things like Facebook work. Instead, they just propagate this myth that the entire Facebook group is inherently racist and everybody who joined the Facebook group is inherently racist because some of the commenters are racist. Well, by that token, you can go to any comment section on literally any website, find the few people who are the grossest, and then slur the entire website via the comments. That is not how any of this works. But when you're trying to paint a narrative, then I guess that you go forward with this sort of nonsense.